I think it's fair to say that the Premier League didn't exactly get off to the best start for Manchester United. That 2-1 defeat to Brighton, it wasn't just the fact that we lost. It was the manner of the football compared to what we saw in the preseason and how that game felt like the 39th game of last season rather than the first game of something new under Erik ten Hag. Kind of took us all by surprise. We've got Brentford on Saturday night, 5:30, away from home. It will not be an easy game in any way, shape or form. And Brentford will come out aggressive and on the press exactly how we expect them to. What I'm going to do in this video is run through my predicted start 11 for that game. And I'll tell you what, there will definitely be some changes. Not only from that team that played, maybe a little tweak to the formation. I'll run through all of it in this video. Make sure you subscribe and drop a like on the video. It does really help United people see if you want to see. It does. I know I say that, but it really, really does. What I want to do now is let's take a look at what the starting 11 was that game against Brighton. Now, obviously, the biggest issue, I believe, was this. Because we had no fit striker, we had no fit number nine, we played Christian Eriksen up front there. It didn't work. It really didn't work. I think we kind of wasted him. And when Eriksen dropped deeper, that's when we actually started to get a bit of an element of control. What I want to do now is run through each part of the pitch. Starting in defence, I think there's a real question to ask about Lisandro Martinez. And I don't necessarily mean about him starting the game, because he will start that. He will start against Brentford, without a shadow of a doubt. What I'm trying to explain here is I don't think you can rule out the possibility of him potentially being brought into midfield for something like that. And then for us to see... I've got two Martinez on the pitch. Not supposed to happen. Let me get Lindelof down there. And depending on Varane's fitness, whether or not Varane comes in there. But what do you think about that? You let me know what you think about that in the comments below. But I think it's a possibility. Because of how bad we were against Brighton in terms of this area of the pitch. I mean, it's been a problem area for a long, long time. But with Fred and McTominay, every time they receive the ball in these positions, let's get these two back there as they were against Brighton. But with Fred there and McTominay, I think it was Fred actually on the left-hand side. It's more like that. Every time they receive the ball from the defenders in this area here, those balls in, their body language was just all wrong. Their body shape was wrong. They received the ball and all they could do was pass it backwards or sideways because they simply weren't accepting enough of that ball in the right way. I think there's a possibility that Martinez gets drafted into midfield to give Erik ten Hag a bit more of what he trusts. Help United play out from the back with the ball. We did well in pre-season. And it just all went out the window in that shape against Brighton. I think there's a chance that Martinez starts there. McTominay gets dropped. And that will make a big, big difference. But I'll be completely honest. I think there's an obvious change that will happen. And surely it's this. Which, of course, changes the shape of up front. We need to have a conversation about who's going to start there. We'll do that a little bit later in the video. But Eriksen has to play deeper against Brentford. Simple as that. Of course, his former club, they'll give him a warm round of applause. And we need him to play inside that deeper role. Because it just changed when we had him down there on the pitch, didn't it? We actually had an element of control. We had an element of build-up, football. We had somebody who was there and he could... I like watching Eriksen, man. He's been brought into the club to basically drag our standards off the floor in terms of actual ability on the ball. Technique, passing range, X, Y, Z. All look towards what Christian Eriksen is doing and try and replicate it. That's what the other midfielders need to do. But I think you're either going to see that. I don't think he's going to throw Fred and McTominay on the bench. And if I'm looking at one of them going to keep his position in the team, I imagine he's probably going to go for Fred, who over the course of the preseason tour certainly was far better than McTominay. McTominay basically continued what he was doing in that preseason tour. Invisible, not showing himself for the ball, rash when he didn't need to be. I mean, he's aggression. is an asset to his game when it's used in the right way, but McTominay needs to be benched. Absolutely, that's one guarantee. Who his partner is depends on whether or not he brings Martinez further up the pitch, because of course Martinez did play there. But if I'm having my prediction, I think Martinez will stay there alongside Maguire. And of course, I've gone nearly 4.5 minutes, really. And I didn't mention how utterly abysmal both Shaw and Delo were against Brighton. And for the love of God, we have to see this. Oh, he's not even down there. Why have I got two Shaws here? I don't know why I've taken one Shaw off just to put one on there. But I want to see Tyrell Massey there. All right? And I don't think that's an outrageous shout in any way, shape, or form. He was so much better than Luke Shaw in the pre... Maybe not so, but he was definitely better than Luke Shaw in the preseason tour. Start him in this game, Eric, please. Malasia and the link-up play with Rashford was better than Shaw's done. His movement, his covering of space, his ability to recover. It's far more suited to this Ten Hag system and style that we've got going forward. And as a trio, I think that could work quite well together there, defensively too. Because Malasia will definitely cover the spaces in behind. That's a change I definitely want to see. And also, as I said, to bring Eriksen back into that deeper midfield role will give Manchester United far more control. And I really want to see that happen. But of course, that brings the question of what happens up here. And the question that everybody's asking, really, is will Ronaldo start? My guess is that he will. Now, by the time this video goes out tomorrow afternoon, maybe Erik ten Hag would have confirmed that Ronaldo's not fit to play. And if Ronaldo's not fit to play, we'll have a little question, we'll have a little conversation about this. But I think Ronaldo will come in. He's had, was it 2 weeks of training now? I think he's had 2 weeks. He still won't be completely fit. He'll probably start and play 60 minutes. And then 65 minutes, it'll be like in the preseason, you know what I mean? When we got towards the end of it and there were people that played 60 minutes and they were taken off X, Y, Z. This will be the next step in Ronaldo getting fit. He's going to stay at Manchester United this season. Not because he wants to be here. And not because the club actually wants him to be here either. I think by the time Erik ten Hag knew that he wanted to leave, he was like, okay, cool. All right, leave. We'll get someone else in. But no one wants him. And Ronaldo's going to stay through a lack of options. But I don't question Ronaldo's professionalism when it comes to when he's on that pitch. He'll want to score goals. He'll want to be the best version of himself. And I think he would do that if he started there against Brentford. Of course, what would happen if he was playing inside the pressing system? Are we going to see spaces? I imagine we will see spaces. I imagine it won't be the exact same as if Martial was there. But if Ronaldo's not, and I think he will be. In fact, there's no point in me really talking about it. I think Ronaldo will start this game. I don't think he'll finish this game. And maybe what you might see in the second half, depending on whether or not Martial's fit or not, you may well see this instead for the last 25 minutes or so. And I'd like to see it. I don't particularly back Rashford to get among the goals, if I'm being brutally honest. I know I think he was semi-saved by an offside flag. Although I think the offside flag might even have been wrong against Brighton. You know, I mean, it was squared by Ronaldo and Rashford just missed it. I was like, how did you not score that? But I think you might see this for the set. And maybe you could see this from the start if Ronaldo's not fit. But I think Ronaldo will be fit to start. And my guess is that Rashford will keep his place and that Ronaldo would go up front. And we'd see a front four of Bruno, Sancho, Rashford and Ronaldo. Not really much was said about this guy's performance against Brighton. But again, Bruno, man, up your levels. Everyone pull your socks up. Everything has to be massively switched from that first game. And for me, the changes that should happen are Malasia coming in there, Eriksen dropping into a deeper position, and I expect to see Ronaldo start up front. That would be my switches from the Brighton game. One thing I'd be interested to see, maybe if Martinez gets brought into midfield, I don't think he'll drop Fred and McTominay, though. And if I'm going to drop one, I'm going to drop McTominay. But you can let me know what you think about that as a predicted starting 11 for the game, as you always do in the comments. Make sure you let me know your predictions as well. I'll be in Glasgow for a wedding, so my match reaction won't be in the normal studio, but you'll have it, as always, on Saturday night. But make sure you drop a like on the video and subscribe to United People's TV, and hopefully United can get 3 points. Because if we go into this game against Liverpool off the back of a defeat and a draw, even worse, two defeats. That is not the way to start a season.